Today we're dealing with a title called Captivity Without Chains. Now people probably won't understand, what does that mean? Can you be a captive without chains? Yes, you can. And I'm going to show you examples in the Bible how we were in captivity without having yokes of iron on us and thinking that we're free, but we weren't. And that's the way it is today in this society. We were brought over here as captives. And today we walk around, we're thinking we're free, but we're still in captivity, but most people don't know. Because when the Lord returns, he's going to gather his captive people. And what I'm going to show you today is how we're still in captivity and we don't have chains on us, but we think we're free. So I'm going to show you how it was in the past and show you how the Lord is looking at it today. Okay, so we're going to start this off in Genesis, the 37th chapter. Genesis 37. And we're going to pick it up at verse 23. Genesis 37 and verse 23. Go ahead.
And it came to pass, when Joseph was come unto his brethren, mm-hmm. that they stripped Joseph out of his coat, his coat of many colors that was on him.
Now, Joseph was a dreamer. His brothers hated him because he was a trick, and he kept telling on them, and that's why his father liked him the most. But his brothers hated him. They hated him so much that they gonna sell him into slavery, which is our first captivity. Okay, but go ahead.
And they took him mm-hmm. and cast him into a pit. And the pit was empty. There was no water in it.
Uh-huh.
And they sat down to eat bread. Mm-hmm. And they lifted up their eyes and looked. And behold, mm-hmm. a company of Ishmaelites came from Gilead with their camels, mm-hmm. bearing spicery and balm mm-hmm. and myrrh, mm-hmm. going to carry it down to Egypt.
Uh-huh.
And Judah said unto his brethren,
mm-hmm.
what profit is it if we slay our brother
uh-huh.
and conceal his blood?
Mm-hmm.
Come, and let us sell him to the Ishmaelites,
mm-hmm.
and let not our hand be upon him.
Uh-huh.
For he is our brother in our flesh,
mm-hmm.
and his brethren were content.
Now, what this tell you that apparently they knew about these Ishmaelites doing slavery, right?
Right.
Because apparently the Ishmaelites, they should have said, no, we ain't buying no humans. But apparently they were it was word around that people was doing this. And they said, let's sell our brother to the Ishmaelite. Okay, but go ahead.
Then there passed by Midianites, mm-hmm. merchantmen.
Uh-huh.
And they drew and lifted up Joseph out of the pit
uh-huh.
and sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites for 20 pieces of silver.
Uh-huh.
And they brought Joseph into Egypt.
So who was your first captives? Ishmaelites, right? Which is what we call what? Arabs. Which got what religion? Muslim. So should we be in that religion at all? Plain and simple. Okay, now skip down to verse 36.
And the Midianites sold him into Egypt
uh-huh.
unto Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh's mm-hmm. and captain of the guard.
So now apparently they had slavery going on in Egypt too, right?
Right.
It's going to be a bigger slavery when it comes to us, but this is what happened with Joseph when he went down. They took him down to Egypt and sold him, okay? Go up to the 39th chapter and pick it up at verse 1 because Potiphar's wife accused Joseph of trying to rape her. He put him in prison, but Joseph was, as long as Joseph was around, the man was blessed. His household was blessed. But when he go to prison, the prison going to be blessed, and Joseph also still can interpret drink. Okay, go ahead, to 39 and verse 1.
And Joseph was brought down to Egypt,
mm-hmm.
and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh,
mm-hmm.
captain of the guard, an Egyptian, bought him of the hands of the Ishmaelites,
mm-hmm.
which had brought him down thither.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord was with Joseph,
mm-hmm.
and he was a prosperous man,
mm-hmm.
and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian.
Uh-huh.
And his master saw that the Lord was with him,
mm-hmm.
and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand.
Uh-huh.
And Joseph found great grace in his sight,
mm-hmm.
and he served him.
Mm-hmm.
And he made him overseer over his house,
uh-huh.
and all that he had he put into his hand.
Now, Joseph got all this control, but he's still a slave, right?
Right.
But he controlled his man's whole house, okay? But now, skip down to verse 17.
And she spake unto him according to these words,
uh-huh.
saying,
mm-hmm.
the Hebrew servant, which thou hast brought unto us, came in unto me to mock me.
Now, she was trying to lay with Joseph. Joseph was trying to get away from her, but she snatched his clothes off,
right,
and he ran out naked.
Right.
And then she going to use that his clothes to accuse him with. Okay, but go ahead.
And it came to pass,
mm-hmm.
as I lifted up my voice and cried,
mm-hmm.
that he left his garment with me and fled out.
Uh-huh.
And it came to pass, when his master heard the words of his wife, when she spake unto him, saying,
mm-hmm.
after this manner did thy servant to me,
mm-hmm.
that his wrath was kindled.
Uh-huh.
And Joseph's master took him and put him into the king's prison,
mm-hmm.
a place where the king's prisoners were bound.
Mm-hmm.
And he was there in the prison.
So now he went from being a slave, but now he in prison. But he's still in captivity. Okay, but go ahead.
But the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners that were in the prison. And whatsoever they did there, he was the doer of it.
Now, ain't that something? Now, he in captivity now, but he got all his control and his power, even in the prison, because the Lord is with him. Okay, but go ahead.
The keeper of the prison looked not to anything that was under his hand, because the Lord was with him. And that which he did, the Lord made it to prosper.
Now, you know, he's making the jail prosper in Egypt. So, you know, they know that the Lord is with this man. Okay, now, go to chapter 41 and pick it up in verse 12. Go ahead.
And there was with us a young man, in Hebrew, servant to the captain of the guard. And we told him, and he interpreted to us our dream.
Now, Pharaoh had a dream. Couldn't nobody interpret all the magicians that he had around him and all his soothsayers. So, but this guy, the one that survived from interpreting the dream in the jail, he told Pharaoh, look, this is a guy that's a Hebrew that can interpret that dream for you. Okay, but go ahead.
To each man according to his dream, he did interpret. And it came to pass, as he interpreted to us, so it was. Me he restored unto mine office, and him he hanged. Then Pharaoh sent and called Joseph, and they brought him hastily out of the dungeon. And he shaved himself and changed his raiment and came in unto Pharaoh. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, I have dreamed the dream, and there is none that can interpret it. And I have heard say of thee, that thou canst understand a dream to interpret it. And Joseph answered Pharaoh, saying, it is not in me. God shall give Pharaoh an answer of peace.
Now, but Joseph knew where he got his authority from, right? So you know, Lord gave him that authority. Okay, now skip down to verse 32.
And for that the dream was double unto Pharaoh twice, it is because the thing is established by God, and God will shortly bring it to pass.
So he said we're going to be some years of famine and some years of plenty. Okay, but go ahead.
Now therefore, let Pharaoh look out a man discreet and wise, and send him over the land of Egypt. Let Pharaoh do this, and let him appoint officers over the land, and take up the fifth part of the land of Egypt in the seven plenteous years. And let them gather all the food of those good years that come, and lay up corn under the hand of Pharaoh, and let them keep food in the city. And that food shall be for store to the land against the 7 years of famine, which shall be in the land of Egypt, that the land perish not through the famine. And the thing was good in the eyes of Pharaoh, and in the eyes of all his servants. And Pharaoh said unto his servants, can we find such a one as this is, a man in whom the spirit of God is? And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, for as much as God hath showed thee all this, there's none so discreet and wise as thou art. Thou shalt be over my house.
Now ain't that something? He went from being a slave when his brother sold him to the Ishmaelites, to the Egyptian. Now he's in Pharaoh's house, and he's going to be over all of Egypt. Okay, go ahead.
And according unto thy word shall all my people be ruled. Only in the throne will I be greater than thou. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, see, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt.
Now ain't that something? But he's still in captivity, right? He ain't in his own land. He ain't back with his family. But he's the second ruler in Egypt. That's how we get sometimes. We think we got so much power and authority and don't realize we still in captivity. We don't control nothing. We still in America right now fighting for civil rights, fighting for the similar treatment or equal treatment, but we in captivity. But I'm going to show you some examples, okay? Now, read verse 45. I'm going to show you something real quick. Go ahead.
And Pharaoh called Joseph's name Zaphnath-Paaneah.
Now, he changed his name. What do they do when they bring you into captivity? They change your name, right? Go ahead.
And he gave him to wife Asenath, the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On. And Joseph went out over all the land of Egypt.
So he had control over all the land of Egypt. Okay, now, go to Genesis, the 46th chapter. And now Joseph's going to bring his family down because the famine is in the land, and he wants his family to survive. But that's the whole reason the Lord sent Joseph down to Egypt anyway. Okay, Genesis 46 and verse 31. Go ahead.
And Joseph said unto his brethren and unto his father's house, I will go up and show Pharaoh and say unto him, my brethren and my father's house, which were in the land of Canaan, are come unto me. And the men are shepherds, for their trade have been to feed cattle.
And that's an abomination to Egyptians. So that's why Pharaoh didn't mind separating them. Okay, go ahead.
And they have brought their flocks and their herds and all that they have. And it shall come to pass, when Pharaoh shall call you and shall say, what is your occupation, that ye shall say, Thy servants' trade have been about cattle from our youth even until now, both we and also our fathers, that ye may dwell in the land of Goshen, for every shepherd is an abomination unto the Egyptians.
So now Joseph then brought all his family down there where he is a captive. And now Israel coming down there with all his people and to come into this land that is not theirs because of what? Food. But they brought all that they had, and now they're coming in on Egypt. Okay, now go to the 50th chapter. And we're going to pick it up at verse 1 to show you how we know Joseph was still in captivity. Okay, Genesis 50 and verse 1. Go ahead.
And Joseph fell upon his father's face and wept upon him and kissed him.
Mm-hmm.
And Joseph commanded his servants, the physicians, to embalm his father.
Uh-huh.
And the physicians embalmed Israel.
Mm-hmm.
And 40 days were fulfilled for him.
Mm-hmm.
For so are fulfilled the days of those which are embalmed.
Mm-hmm.
And the Egyptians mourned for him 70 days.
Uh-huh.
And when the days of his mourning were past, Joseph spake unto the house of Pharaoh, saying, if now I have found grace in your eyes, speak, I pray you, in the ears of Pharaoh, saying, my father made me swear, saying, lo, I die, and my grave which I have digged for me in the land of Canaan, there shalt thou bury me. Now, therefore, let me go up, I pray thee, and bury my father, and
minute.
I will come again.
And why he got to ask him to go? If you free, you should have to ask. You just say, look, I'm going to go take my father over here and bury him. But he had to get permission because Pharaoh owned him, right?
Yeah.
He didn't own Jacob and his family, but eventually that's what's going to happen. But did he have chains on? No. Anytime that he had wanted to do something, wherever he dwelled, he did not have a chain on him at all. But he was a captive the whole time, okay? Now, let's go see how they did with Israel. Let's go to Exodus, the first chapter. Exodus 1, and we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Exodus 1 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Now these are the names of the children of Israel, which came into Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Every man in his household came with Jacob, Reuben, Simeon, Levi, and Judah, Issachar, Zebulun, and Benjamin, Dan, and Naphtali, Gad, and Asher. And all the souls that came out of the loins of Jacob were 70 souls, for Joseph was in Egypt already. And Joseph died, and all his brethren, and all that generation. And the children of Israel were fruitful, and increased abundantly, and multiplied, and waxed exceeding mighty, and the land was filled with them.
Now he came down there with 70. Now they outnumbered the Egyptians. Israel just having babies like rabbits. Okay, but go ahead.
Now there arose up a new king over Egypt, which knew not Joseph. And he said unto his people, behold, the people of the children of Israel are more and mightier than we.
Now this king came up, but he didn't know Joseph, right? But Joseph was the second ruler in Egypt for a long time.
Yeah.
How can you forget that?
Yeah.
Because he wasn't important to him. Plain and simple. Okay, but go ahead.
Come on. Let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply and it come to pass that when there falleth out any war, they join also unto our enemies and fight against us, and so get them up out of the land. Therefore, they did set over them taskmasters to afflict them with their burden.
Now, what they do, they made them public slaves. And they're doing this because they want control over them so they'll have control of it, so won't nobody come in and outnumber them. Okay, go ahead.
And they built for Pharaoh treasure cities, Pithom and Ramses. But the more they afflicted them, the more they multiplied and grew. And they were grieved because of the children of Israel.
Just because you make them work hard don't mean they ain't going to go home. They're going to go home. Okay? But now go to verse 13. Go ahead.
And the Egyptians made the children of Israel to serve with rigor.
Now, they just made them work hard, right? Because they wanted them to stop having babies, but they couldn't do it. So Pharaoh put in a birth control by having them kill all the male child, right? But that didn't work. So now, go to Exodus, the 10th chapter. Because now they're in captivity again, but they don't have chains. They just got taskmasters on them, but they are public slaves, okay? Just Exodus 10 and verse 8. Go ahead.
And Moses and Aaron were brought again unto Pharaoh. And he said unto them, go, serve the Lord your God. But who are they that shall go?
Now, he asked them a question. Look, he wants to know because he acts like he owned Israel, right? I'm asking you, who is going? Okay, go ahead.
And Moses said, mm-hmm. we will go with our young and with our old, mm-hmm. with our sons and with our daughters, uh-huh. with our flocks and with our herds mm-hmm. will we go, uh-huh. for we must hold a feast unto the Lord.
So now they in captivity, but they got flocks and herds, right? But you also notice he said children too, because guess what? Don't the curses say that you're not going to enjoy your children because they're going to go what? In the captivity, right? So he putting them on the list, the children, the flocks, and the herd, okay? Now, skip down to verse 24.
And Pharaoh called unto Moses and said, mm-hmm. go ye, serve the Lord. Uh-huh. Only let your flocks and your herds be stayed. Mm-hmm. Let your little ones also go with you.
He said, you can go with the children, but leave the flocks and the herd. Mm-hmm. That's telling him who owned the flocks and the herd. Pharaoh, right?
That's right.
He said, let them be stayed. Okay, go ahead.
And Moses said, mm-hmm. thou must give us also sacrifices and burnt offerings, mm-hmm. that we may sacrifice unto the Lord our God. Uh-huh. Our cattle also shall go with us. Mm-hmm. There shall not an hoof be left behind. Uh-huh. For therefore must be take to serve the Lord our God, mm-hmm. and we know not with what we must serve the Lord uh-huh. until we come thither.
Now he telling him, you got to give us cattle, right? Even though, because we don't know how to serve this God, but he's telling Pharaoh, you got to give us this stuff. Okay, go ahead.
But the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart, uh-huh. and he would not let them go.
Ain't that something? So who's in control? You. Pharaoh, okay? Now, go to the 50th chapter. I mean, the 40th chapter. No, I'm jumping too fast. You go to the 12th chapter. Exodus 12, and we're going to pick up at verse 31. Exodus 12 and verse 31. Go ahead.
And he called for Moses and Aaron by night mm-hmm. and said, uh-huh. rise up mm-hmm. and get you forth from among my people.
Now, this is after the Lord put that last plague on Pharaoh, yeah. Yeah. killed all the firstborn in Egypt. Now he going to let them take what they want to take. Okay, go ahead.
Both ye and the children of Israel, and go, uh-huh. serve the Lord mm-hmm. as ye have said. Uh-huh. Also take your flocks and your herds uh-huh. as ye have said, mm-hmm. and be gone uh-huh. and bless me also.
Because after the Lord put that whooping on them, he said, take what y'all want. Your flocks, your herds, your children, everything. But now it's yours. Okay, go ahead.
And the Egyptians were urging upon the people mm-hmm. that they might send them out of the land in haste. Mm-hmm. But they said, we be all dead men. Uh-huh. And the people took their dough before it was leavened, mm-hmm. their kneading troughs being bound up in their clothes mm-hmm. upon their shoulders. Uh-huh. And the children of Israel did according to the word of Moses. Mm-hmm. And they borrowed of the Egyptians mm-hmm. jewels of silver and jewels of gold mm-hmm. and raiment.
Because the Lord put so much fear on them because he showed them he'd kill them. So they gave up everything. Okay, go ahead.
And the Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians mm-hmm. so that they lent unto them such things as they required. Mm-hmm. And they spoiled the Egyptians. Uh-huh. And the children of Israel journeyed from Ramses to Succoth, mm-hmm. about 600,000 on foot that were men mm-hmm. beside children.
600,000 just the men now. They ain't counting the women and children, but you know that's a huge group. If you got 600,000 men coming out of captivity at one time, okay, go ahead.
And a mixed multitude went up also with them mm-hmm. in flocks and herds, mm-hmm. even very much cattle.
Now, they got all these cattle, flocks and herds, but they was in captivity, so they had to ask Pharaoh for this. He didn't want to give it to them, but when they wanted to get rid of them, then they gave them everything they wanted, right? Right. So they didn't go out empty. Okay, now, go to Leviticus 26 chapter. Now the children of Israel are in the wilderness. And the Lord going to tell them what they can and cannot do. And if you do this, I'll bless you. If you don't do this, I will curse you. To see what's going to happen to Israel now, because they free. They out of bondage of Egypt. Okay, Leviticus 26 and verse 1. Go ahead.
He shall make you no idols, mm-hmm. nor graven image, mm-hmm. neither rear you up a standing image, mm-hmm. neither shall ye set up any image of stone in your land uh-huh. to bow down unto it, mm-hmm. for I am the Lord your God. Uh-huh. Ye shall keep my Sabbaths and reverence my sanctuary, mm-hmm. I am the Lord. Uh-huh. If ye walk in my statutes and keep my commandments and do them, mm-hmm. then I will give you rain in due season, mm-hmm. and the land shall yield her increase, uh-huh. and the trees of the field shall yield their fruit, mm-hmm. and your threshing shall reach unto the vintage, mm-hmm. and the vintage shall reach unto the sowing time, uh-huh. and ye shall eat your bread to the full, mm-hmm. and dwell in your land safely.
All you gotta do is keep the commandments, and the Lord will bless you. And you will dwell safe. Okay, but go ahead.
And I will give peace in the land, mm-hmm. and ye shall lie down, mm-hmm. and none shall make you afraid. Uh-huh. And I will rear evil beasts out of the land, mm-hmm. neither shall the sword go through your land. Uh-huh. And ye shall chase your enemies, mm-hmm. and they shall fall before you by the sword.
Now, why wouldn't you not do that? You get all them blessings, all you gotta do is keep the commandment, okay? Now, skip down to verse 14.
But if you will not hearken unto me, and will not do all these commandments, and if you shall despise my statutes, or if your soul abhor my judgment, so that you will not do all my commandments, but that ye break my covenant, I also will do this unto you. I will even appoint over you terror, consumption, and the burning egg that shall consume the eyes, and cause sorrow of heart. And you shall sow your seed in vain, for your enemies shall eat it. And I will set my face against you, and ye shall be slain before your enemies. They that hate you shall reign over you.
Now, when they reign over you, that means they got control over you, right? So if you listen to the blessing and the curses, you can be saying, no, well, I ain't let that happen to me. That's what you would think. But I'm going to show you what's going to happen. Okay, go ahead.
Ye shall flee when none pursue of you. And if ye will not yet for all this hearken unto me, then I will punish you seven times more for your sins.
So now, because the Lord said, you better do what he say, otherwise he'll hurt you. Okay, now skip down to verse 23.
And if ye will not be reformed by me by these things, but will walk contrary unto me, then will I also walk contrary unto you, and will punish you yet seven times for your sins. And I will bring a sword upon you that shall avenge the quarrel of my covenant. And when ye are gathered together within your cities, I will send a pestilence among you, and ye shall be delivered into the hand of the enemy.
Now you're going to be delivered what? Into the hand of your enemy. And what do they normally do if they don't kill you? They take you as a captive. Yep. Just that simple. Okay, now, skip down to verse 32.
And I will bring the land into desolation, and your enemies which dwell therein shall be astonished at it. And I will scatter you among the heathen, and will draw out a sword after you. And your land shall be desolate, and your cities waste. Then shall the land enjoy her Sabbath, as long as it lieth desolate, and ye be in the enemy's land. Even then shall the land rest, and enjoy her Sabbath. As long as it lieth desolate, it shall rest, because it did not rest in your Sabbath when ye dwelt upon it.
That's a clue to say. And what? They ain't gonna do right, right? So all the Lord told him, look, you do this, I'll bless you. You do this, I will curse you. Just that simple. Okay, now, let's go to 2 Kings, the 17th chapter. 2 Kings 17. And show you now. Matter of fact, these are the ones that were 20 years old and under that came into the promised land, because the ones that was 20 years and older didn't make it out of the wilderness. Only Joshua and Caleb. So we know it's the children of our ancestors that got into the promised land, and this is how they act, okay? 2 Kings 17 and verse 6. Go ahead.
In the ninth year of Hoshea, the king of Assyria took Samaria and carried Israel away into Assyria and placed them in Halah and in Habor by the river of Gozan and in the cities of the Medes.
Now, the Lord allowed the Assyrians to come in and take Israel into captivity and take them out of their land. Okay, go ahead.
For so it was, that the children of Israel had sinned against the Lord their God, which had brought them up out of the land of Egypt, from under the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and had feared other gods, and walked in the statutes of the heathen, whom the Lord cast out from before the children of Israel, and of the kings of Israel, which they had made. And the children of Israel did secretly those things that were not right against the Lord their God, and they built them high places in all their cities, from the tower of the watchmen to the fence city.
You know, this reminds me of Masons. They got so much secret, right? But all these Israelites belong to these groups, right?
Right.
They taking all these devilish vows, and they're doing it in secret. And Israel ain't changed to this day.
No.
In fact, it's called Freemasonry. So you're supposed to be free to get in it. And when it started, we wasn't free. But we're fighting to get in it now, right? But they doing this stuff in secret, thinking the Lord ain't seeing. And most of them are religious people. Okay, but go ahead.
And they set them up images in groves in every high hill and under every green tree. And there they burnt incense in all the high places, as did the heathen whom the Lord carried away before them, and wrought wicked things to provoke the Lord to anger.
Now, the Lord probably looking at you and said, didn't I tell them, don't do this? And they doing exactly what I said don't do. Okay, go ahead.
But they served idols. Whereof the Lord had said unto them, ye shall not do this thing. But the Lord testified against Israel and against Judah by all the prophets and by all the seers, saying, turn ye from your evil ways and keep my commandments and my statutes according to all the law which I commanded your father and which I sent to you by my servants, the prophets. Notwithstanding, they would not hear, but hardened their necks like to the neck of their fathers that did not believe in the Lord their God.
Ain't that something? From generation to generation, stiff-necked people. And the Lord told them what not to do, and they're doing it anyway. Okay, go ahead.
And they rejected his statutes and his covenant that he made with their father and his testimonies which he testified against them. And they followed vanity and became vain and went after the heathen that were round about them concerning whom the Lord had charged them that they should not do like them.
Ain't that something? Israel ain't changing today. You bring up a new religion, we're trying to get in it. If you don't let us in, we scream discrimination. But they won't stay with their own God. They want to serve everybody else's God. Okay, go ahead.
And they left all the commandments of the Lord their God and made them molten images, even two calves, and made it grow and worshiped all the host of heaven and served Baal. And they caused their sons and their daughters to pass through the fire and used divination and enchantments and sold themselves to do evil in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger.
Israel's still doing all this stuff today except for making their kids pass through the fire. But if they can get away with it, they wouldn't do it.
That's right.
Because they wouldn't let anybody talk to them and tell them what their plight going to be. To tell me, divine something to me. But they're going against the Lord because the Lord said, don't use divination. Okay, but go ahead.
Therefore, the Lord was very angry with Israel and removed them out of his sight. There was none left but the tribe of Judah only. Also, Judah kept not the commandments of the Lord their God, but walked in the statutes of Israel, which they made.
Now, he thought he going to say, at least Judah going to be right.
Nope.
Judah went just as bad. Okay, go ahead.
And the Lord rejected all the seed of Israel and afflicted them and delivered them into the hand of spoilers until he had cast them out of his sight. For he rent Israel from the house of David and they made Jeroboam the son of Nebat king. And Jeroboam drove Israel from following the Lord and made them sin a great sin.
Because Jeroboam, you know, he was a king over the people. And then the people said, we're going to go back to Jerusalem so we can keep the feast. He said, no, I'm going to make some new feasts. And he made some new priests and everything, and they went all the way contrary against the Lord. And the Lord remembered that. Okay, but go ahead.
For the children of Israel walked in all the sins of Jeroboam, which he did. They departed not from them until the Lord removed Israel out of his sight, as he had said by all his servants, the prophets. So was Israel carried away out of their own land to Assyria unto this day. And the king of Assyria brought men from Babylon and from Cuthah and from Abar and from Hamath and from Sepharvaim and placed them in the cities of Samaria instead of the children of Israel. And they possessed Samaria and dwelt in the cities thereof.
Ain't that something? Now, he replaced you by bringing somebody else back in so you can't come back later and say, this is my land. Because that's how you lost your land. That's why people over there right now claiming it's their land and you in captivity. Ain't nothing changed. The Lord did this with Israel because Israel been hard-headed for years. Thousands of years. And when he gave them control, they couldn't handle a little bit. Because after this, going to come up a world ruler. He's going to rule the world. You couldn't handle a part of the world as a nation. Okay? Now, let's go to see what happened with Jeremiah when they went into captivity. This is what Jeremiah wrote them. Go to Jeremiah, the 29th chapter. Because the Lord wants Israel to survive, but he let them know, I put you in captivity because you was hard-headed, but this is what you're going to do while you're in captivity. Okay? And this is going to sound like what we got going on today with us. Okay? Genesis, Jeremiah 29, and read verse 1, and then we're going to skip down to verse 4. Go ahead.
Now these are the words of the letter that Jeremiah the prophet sent from Jerusalem unto the residue of the elders, which were carried away captive, and to the priests, and to the prophets, and to all the people whom Nebuchadnezzar had carried away captive from Jerusalem to Babylon.
Let's skip down to verse 4.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, unto all that are carried away captives, whom I have caused to be carried away from Jerusalem unto Babylon. Build ye houses, and dwell in them, and plant gardens, and eat the fruit of them. Take ye wives, and beget sons and daughters, and take wives for your sons, and give your daughters to husbands, that they may bear sons and daughters, that ye may be increased there, and not diminished. And seek the peace of the city whither I have caused you to be carried away captive, and pray unto the Lord for it. For in the peace thereof shall ye have peace.
So now you're going to go into captivity, you're going to live like you're a regular citizen, and you're going to increase like a nation of people, but pray to the Lord for peace. Why you there? But you going, for sure. Now, are they in chains? No. You can't build houses with chains, can you?
No.
So the bottom line is, he let them know, you going to be in captivity, but just pray for peace. Why you there? This is what happened to Israel every time they went into captivity. Okay? Now, it wasn't until the slave trade happened that they put chains of yoke or iron around you, but all these times, you were in captivity without chains. Okay? Now, let's go to Daniel, the second chapter. Daniel 2? Because Daniel was part of the people that were taken to Babylon, and they too, were the Medes and the Persians, but they too were in captivity, and we're going to find out how they was in captivity, but they wouldn't have no chains either, okay? Daniel 2 and verse 25. Go ahead.
Then Arioch brought in Daniel before the king in haste, mm-hmm. and said thus unto him, mm-hmm. I found a man of the captives of Judah.
The man of a who? The captives of Judah. He had a dream, and Daniel going to be the only one to interpret the dream for him. But he said, I have found a man of the captives of Judah. Okay, go ahead.
And will make known unto the king the interpretation.
Okay, now, skip down to verse 45, because we're not going to read all about the dream. We read about the situation that Daniel was in. Verse 45. Okay, go ahead.
For as much as thou sawest that the stone was cut out of the mountain without hands, mm-hmm. and that it break in pieces the iron, the brass, mm-hmm. the clay, the silver, and the gold, mm-hmm. the great God hath made known to the king what shall come to pass hereafter. Mm-hmm. And the dream is certain, and the interpretation thereof sure.
Uh-huh.
Then the king Nebuchadnezzar fell upon his face, mm-hmm. and worshipped Daniel, and commanded that they should offer an oblation and sweet odors unto him.
Uh-huh.
The king answered unto Daniel and said, of a truth it is, mm-hmm. that your God is a God of gods, mm-hmm. and a Lord of kings, mm-hmm. and a revealer of secrets, seeing thou couldst reveal this secret.
Mm-hmm.
Then the king made Daniel a great man,
mm-hmm.
and gave him many great gifts,
uh-huh.
and made him ruler over the whole province of Babylon,
uh-huh.
and chief of the governors over all the wise men of Babylon.
That's a huge promotion for a captive, ain't it? It's the same thing happened with Joseph, wasn't it?
Right.
So he made him the second ruler of Babylon. Okay, read verse 49.
Then Daniel requested of the king,
mm-hmm.
and he set Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, mm-hmm. over the affairs of the province of Babylon,
uh-huh.
but Daniel sat in the gate of the king.
Ain't there something? Daniel said, look, man, can you promote my boys over here?
Right.
Hook my buddies up? And they made him over the province, gave him position, right? Making you think like they big shots, right? But they in captivity, okay? Now, go to Daniel, the fifth chapter. And now Belteshazzar is king. And he came up either immediately after Nebuchadnezzar or after his father. We don't know for sure because we know, but he did become a king, okay? But Daniel is still alive, so we know it wasn't that long of a time, okay? Daniel 5 and verse 10. Remember now, he's the chief second ruler in Babylon, and Belteshazzar is the king now, okay? Daniel 5 and verse 10. Go ahead.
Now the queen, by reason of the words of the king, mm-hmm. and his lords, came into the banquet house.
Mm-hmm.
And the queen spake and said,
mm-hmm.
O king, live forever.
Uh-huh.
Let not thy thoughts trouble thee,
mm-hmm.
nor let thy countenance be changed.
Mm-hmm.
There is a man in thy kingdom,
mm-hmm.
in whom is the spirit of the holy God.
Uh-huh.
And in the days of thy father, mm-hmm. light and understanding and wisdom,
mm-hmm.
like the wisdom of the gods,
mm-hmm.
was found in him. Whom the king Nebuchadnezzar, thy father,
mm-hmm.
the king, mm-hmm. I say, thy father,
mm-hmm.
made master of the magicians,
mm-hmm.
astrologers, Chaldeans, mm-hmm. and soothsayers.
Now, Belteshazzar knew that, because if his wife know it, he know it. But he didn't give him no problem, because apparently my dad made you second ruler, but I'm king now. So, is Daniel got any position now? He just got title. They give us a lot of title.
Yeah.
But you don't have no power. You could be CEO or this and that and the other, but you ain't got no power. You think you do, but you're in captivity. We had a black president, but we get. Did your life get better? Mine didn't. Am I telling the truth? He wasn't no Israelite anyway, but that's another story. But the bottom line is, just because they give you a title don't mean you got no power and no authority. Okay, but go ahead.
For as much as an excellent spirit,
mm-hmm.
and knowledge, and understanding,
mm-hmm.
interpreting of dreams,
mm-hmm.
and showing of hard sentences,
mm-hmm.
and dissolving of doubts,
mm-hmm.
were found in the same Daniel,
mm-hmm.
whom the king named Belteshazzar.
Mm-hmm.
Now let Daniel be called,
mm-hmm.
and he will show the interpretation.
Now you know you got to call him. You up here sitting where letting these other guys try to tell you what the dream, they can't tell you nothing. You got to go get Daniel, okay? But go ahead.
Then was Daniel brought in before the king.
Mm-hmm.
And the king spake and said unto Daniel,
mm-hmm.
art thou that Daniel,
mm-hmm.
which art of the children of the captivity of Judah?
What? He didn't remember he the second ruler now, the chief governor, but he remembered the captive, right? That's the only title he remembered.
Yeah.
That's all the props he wanted to give him, right? Plain and simple. Okay, but go ahead.
Whom the king, my father, mm-hmm. brought out of Jewry.
Uh-huh. So now he said, but my father brought you out of Jewry. Well, what? Out of captivity. But you still a captive to Belteshazzar, right? Mm-hmm. He let him know that because he could have called him by his title. Governor of the chief magician. He ain't call him that. Plain and simple. Now, Let's go skip down to verse 26. Go ahead.
This is the interpretation of the thing.
Uh-huh.
Mene,
mm-hmm.
God have numbered thy kingdom
mm-hmm.
and finished it.
Uh-huh.
Tekel, thou art weighed in the balances mm-hmm. and art found wanting.
Uh-huh.
Perez,
mm-hmm.
thy kingdom is divided
mm-hmm.
and given to the Medes and Persians.
Mm-hmm.
They commanded Belshazzar, and they clothed Daniel with scarlet
mm-hmm.
and put a chain of gold around about his neck
uh-huh.
and made a proclamation concerning him
mm-hmm.
that he should be the third ruler in the kingdom.
Wait, but now he was the second before. Now you drop him down a notch. I guess the queen got second spot. So he get the third. But now they give him a title again. But is he going to do any good? No. Just give him the title. Okay, but go ahead.
And that night was mm-hmm. Belshazzar, the king of the Chaldeans, slain.
Mm-hmm.
And Darius the Median took the kingdom,
mm-hmm.
being about 62 years old.
So now, has he got any position at all now?
No.
None.
Because
the whole kingdom been taken over.
Right.
Third rulership gone. They ain't acknowledge the second rulership. Right? Because they in captivity. You're going to be always considered a captive no matter where you go because that's what the Lord put on you. Just that simple. Okay, now, let's go to Ezra, the first chapter, because Israel did go back into their land. Lord allowed them to go back and rebuild. But when they got back over there, you know what they did? Same old thing. Right? Messed up again. And the Lord said, you know what? I tried to help y'all, but y'all ain't want to listen. I tried to be nice, but now we're going to see how they're going to go back. Okay, Ezra 1 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Now, in the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia,
mm-hmm.
that the word of the Lord by mouth of Jeremiah mm-hmm. might be fulfilled,
mm-hmm.
the Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus, king of Persia,
mm-hmm.
that he made a proclamation throughout all his kingdom
mm-hmm.
and put it also in writing, saying,
mm-hmm.
thus saith Cyrus, king of Persia,
mm-hmm.
the Lord God of heaven hath given me all the kingdoms of the earth,
mm-hmm.
and ye have charged me to build him an house at Jerusalem,
mm-hmm.
which is in Judah.
Uh-huh.
Who is there among you of all his people?
Mm-hmm.
His God be with him,
mm-hmm.
and let him go up to Jerusalem, which is in Judah,
mm-hmm.
and build the house of the Lord God of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
He is the God which is in Jerusalem.
So now what are you giving them? He's giving them permission to end their captivity and go back to Jerusalem and rebuild the house of the Lord, which Cyrus giving them authority to do. Okay, now go over to Ezra the second chapter. And we're going to read verse 1, and then we're going to skip down to verse 64, because we ain't going to finna count all these people. Ezra 2 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Now these are the children of the province that went up out of the captivity
mm-hmm.
of those which have been carried away,
mm-hmm.
whom Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, had carried away unto Babylon,
mm-hmm.
and came again unto Jerusalem mm-hmm. and Judah, mm-hmm. every one unto his city.
Now you're going to call up all these people. Now skip down to verse 64. We're just going to go to get the total, okay?
The whole congregation together was 42,303.
And now that's a big number, ain't it? But that ain't all that went back. Because some people just were saying, look, I'm going to just stay here.
Right.
You know, because that's where it was when they ended slavery here in America. We should all jetted back to Africa if that's where we're from, right?
Right.
But most of them said, no, well, I got some land here. I'm going to stay here. We still ain't got that 40 acres and a mule, but we had a little property. Okay, but now, go ahead.
Beside their servants mm-hmm. and their maids,
uh-huh.
of whom there were 7,337.
Wait a minute now, they got servants and maids too? Mm. Don't some of us have, you know, some Israelites got some maids in their houses. They got servants in their house. They got employees. But they are captives, right? They're in captivity without chains, right?
Yep.
Do that sound similar to what we're dealing with? Because you tell somebody that ain't got no word, no understanding, oh, man, you in captivity. No, man, I'm free. Are you? Truly? What do you control? You might have a lot of money in the bank and this, that, and the other, but even LeBron James is in captivity.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, how much money you think you got? If you ain't controlling your land, you ain't captivity. Just that simple. Okay, but go ahead.
And there were among them 200 singing men mm. and singing women.
Uh-huh.
Their horses were 736.
Uh-huh.
Their mules, 245.
Uh-huh.
Their camels,
mm-hmm.
435.
Mm-hmm.
Their asses, 6,720.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the chief of the fathers,
mm-hmm.
when they came to the house of the Lord, which is at Jerusalem,
mm-hmm.
offered freely for the house of God
mm-hmm.
to set it up in his place.
Uh-huh.
They gave after their ability mm-hmm. unto the treasure of the work 61,000 drams of gold
uh-huh.
and 5,000 pounds of silver
mm-hmm.
and 100 priest garments.
I mean, they ain't poor now, but they in captivity, right?
Yeah.
Now, don't you know if we all got together and kept our money in our society like everybody else do, we would be rich too, right? But what we do? I'm going over here and spend my money over here. We go get contractors that don't look like us. We get plumbers that don't look like us. We get hair people that don't look like us. We get nail people that don't look like us. We get clothing from people that don't look like us. And we spend billions of dollars, got the money, and still don't know we in captivity. It ain't changed. And we ain't got a chain on us, but we think we're free. They'll think I'm some conspiracy theorist. But I'm just reading book, right? And you reading your history in the past all the way up to this present day. And nothing changed. Read the last verse.
So the priests and the Levites and some of the people and the singers and the porters and the Nethinim dwelt in their cities and all Israel in their cities.
Ain't that something? So everybody who wanted to go back could go back. But most of them just, some of them stayed because they was doing good, but they made a contribution to the house of the Lord. And that wasn't no cheap contribution.
Nope.
They left with a lot of material. Okay, but now, let's go to Deuteronomy the 6th chapter. Deuteronomy 6. Because we have to read about our forefathers. It ain't no good history, but it's us. And, you know, truth got to come out. And sooner or later, somebody going to recognize that y'all are the chosen people. Recognize that y'all sinned against your God and that y'all need to turn back to your God and they need to follow. Just that simple, okay? Deuteronomy 6 and verse 10. Go ahead.
And it shall be, when the Lord thy God shall have brought thee into the land which he sware unto thy fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to give thee great and goodly cities, which thou buildest not, and houses full of all good things, which thou filledest not, and wells digged, which thou diggedest not, vineyards and olive trees, which thou plantest not, when thou shalt have eaten and be full, then beware lest thou forget the Lord, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage.
Ain't Lord said, I set this place up for y'all. The wells is dig already. The trees already planted. Crops and everything planted. All you got to do is move in. As soon as you get moved in, you start eating, you get fat, and you don't remember the Lord no more. Because the book says Jeshurun waxed fat and kicked, didn't he?
Yep.
Israel do it all the time. Oh, I did this on my own. You ain't did nothing. Lord set you up. Okay, go ahead.
Thou shalt fear the Lord thy God and serve him and shall swear by his name. Ye shall not go after other gods of the gods of the people which are round about you. For the Lord thy God is a jealous God among you, lest the anger of the Lord thy God be kindled against thee and destroy thee from off the face of the earth. Ye shall not tempt the Lord your God as ye tempted him in Massah. Ye shall diligently keep the commands of the Lord your God and his testimonies and his statutes, which he have commanded thee. And thou shalt do that which is right and good in the sight of the Lord, that it may be well with thee, and that thou mayest go in and possess the good land which the Lord sware unto thy father, to cast out all thine enemies from before thee, as the Lord hath spoken.
Ain't that something? Because we know the Lord didn't give us that land because of our righteousness. He gave us that land because the people was in it was wicked. And it was good land, and he gave it to us. Okay, now, let's go to Isaiah, the 5th chapter. Isaiah 5, and we're going to pick it up at verse 1. Isaiah 5 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Now will I sing to my well-beloved the song of my beloved touching his vineyard. My well-beloved hath a vineyard and a very fruitful hill.
Now, you're going to find out later that this vineyard is the Lord's talking about the children of Israel, the nation of Israel. Okay, go ahead.
And he fenced it and gathered out the stones thereof and planted it with the choicest vine and built a tower in the midst of it and also made a wine press therein. And he looked that it should bring forth grapes and it brought forth wild grapes.
Now, didn't he tell you that he gave you this pleasant land? You ain't have to do nothing. All you had to do was move in. He did. He fixed it up for you. And he thought he planted good seed, but he planted some wild seed. And that's what came up. Okay, but go ahead.
And now, O inhabitants of Jerusalem and men of Judah, judge, I pray you, betwixt me and my vineyard. What can have been done more to my vineyard that I have not done in it? Wherefore, when I looked that it should bring forth grapes, brought it forth wild grapes.
Now he said, look, I didn't make this thing perfect. What else could I have done that my seed would come up not wild? But it came up wild. Okay, go ahead. Reverse. Okay, we'll hold it right there. Let's go to Psalms 80 chapter. Put your marker here. We're coming right back. Psalms 80. And we're going to pick it up at verse 8. Psalms 80. And verse 8. Go ahead.
Thou hast brought a vine out of Egypt. Mm-hmm. Thou hast cast out the heathen and planted it.
Now, don't that sound like that vineyard?
Yeah.
He said, you brought a vine out of Egypt. Go ahead.
Thou prepared its room before it,
uh-huh,
and didst cause it to take deep root,
mm-hmm,
and it filled the land.
Uh-huh.
The hills were covered with the shadow of it,
mm-hmm,
and the boughs thereof were like the goodly cedars.
Mm-hmm.
She sent out her boughs unto the sea,
mm-hmm,
and her branches unto the river.
Uh-huh.
Why hast thou then broken down her hedges,
mm-hmm,
so that all they which pass by the way do pluck her?
And he said, now why you don't protect this vineyard no more? Everybody is plucking this vineyard. Okay, go ahead.
The boar out of the wood doth waste it.
Uh-huh.
And the wild beast of the field doth devour it.
Now he's using animals, but he's no, what he's really talking about, he's talking about other nations,
right,
coming in and destroying you,
right,
Israel. Okay, go ahead.
Return.
Mm-hmm.
We beseech thee, O God of hosts.
Uh-huh.
Look down from heaven, mm-hmm, and behold, and visit this vine.
Uh-huh.
And the vineyard which thy right hand hath planted,
mm-hmm,
and the branch that thou madest strong for thyself.
So now he said, you know, look down, help us, right? But when I wanted to help y'all, I planted a good seed. And it came up wild. And I told you, if you don't do what I say do, you're going to, the curse is going to come upon you. Okay, go ahead.
It is burned with fire.
Uh-huh.
It is cut down.
Mm-hmm.
They perish at the rebuke of thy countenance.
Because who's sending the trouble? The Lord is. The man ain't doing this to you. The Lord allowing the man to do this to you.
That's right.
And he allowing the man to do it because you wouldn't listen.
That's right.
So you are the vineyard. Okay, now let's go back to Isaiah the 5th chapter. And pick it up at verse 5. Go ahead.
And now go to.
Mm-hmm.
I will tell you what I will do to my vineyard.
Uh-huh.
I will take away the hedge thereof,
mm-hmm,
and it shall be eaten up,
uh-huh,
and break down the wall thereof,
mm-hmm,
and it shall be trodden down.
Uh-huh.
And I will lay it waste. It shall not be pruned,
mm-hmm,
nor digged,
mm-hmm,
but there shall come up briars and thorns.
Mm-hmm.
I will also command the clouds that they rain no rain upon it.
Uh-huh.
For the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel,
mm-hmm,
and the man of Judah his pleasant plant.
Mm-hmm.
And he looked for judgment,
uh-huh,
but behold, oppression,
mm-hmm,
for righteousness, mm-hmm, but behold, a cry.
Ain't that something? He planted a good seed, and it came up wild and disobeying everything he said. So what he had to do here to pull back and let all the nations come up and spoil Israel, and you still being spoiled today. You don't know it. We know it, but the nation don't know it. All these false prophets out here teaching people about their plight and their opinion. But ain't nobody speaking out the Bible. You ain't gonna hear no history lesson like this out of the book, and I ain't even opened up a history book yet. It's all right in here. Fits you like a glove. Just that simple, okay? Now, let's go to Jeremiah the 12th chapter. Jeremiah 12, and we're going to pick it up in verse 1. It's amazing all this is in the book, and ain't nobody talking about us. Got all these people with all these degrees and letters behind their name and letters in front of their name, and you can't figure out 3 days and 3 nights. And you can't figure out that this Bible is talking about Israel as not the people that they say it is. You can read Revelation 2 and 9 and Revelation 3 and 9, but you still can't decipher that Israel is a black man or man of color. Right? Just that simple, okay? Jeremiah 12 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Righteous art thou, O Lord,
mm-hmm,
when I plead with thee.
Uh-huh.
Yet let me talk with thee of thy judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore doth the way of the wicked prosper?
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore are all they happy that deal very treacherously?
Ain't that something? Because the things that they did to us, and they still doing to us, and they prosper. Why? Because the Lord said he's going to make you jealous by a foolish nation.
That's right. That is no
nation. Right? Ain't that book?
Yeah.
But you have to ask, why everybody getting this stuff? That man ain't no good. He got all his money in the bank. That woman ain't no good. He got all his money in the bank. Because the Lord is allowing it. Just that simple. Okay, go ahead.
Thou hast planted them.
Mm-hmm.
Yea,
uh-huh,
they have taken root.
Mm-hmm.
They grow. Yea, they bring forth fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Thou art near in their mouth,
uh-huh,
and far from their reign.
Oh, they love Jesus now. They love the name, but they ain't going to do what he say.
That's right.
But they prosper. Look at all these rich preachers they got out here. They got jets, Rolls Royces. Yeah, I don't even want to talk about their clothes. I even heard one of them talking about he spent like a $16,000 dog. I wish I would be sitting in that audience and you told me you went and bought a $16,000 dog with my money. That'd have been the last day for him. Cool. I'm just saying, they sitting there clapping.
Right, right.
Now, if that ain't a foolish nation, I don't know what is.
Teach.
I want a bone or something from that dog.
Right, for
real. Tail or ear or something. $16,000 dog. Skip down to verse 6.
For even thy brethren,
uh-huh,
and the house of thy father,
uh-huh,
even they have dealt treacherously with thee.
Uh-huh.
Yea, mm-hmm, they have called a multitude after thee.
Uh-huh.
Believe them not,
mm-hmm,
though they speak fair words unto thee.
He said, they gonna come to you all smooth and talking and everything. He said, believe them not, because they not from the Lord. Okay, go ahead.
I have forsaken mine house.
Uh-huh.
I have left mine heritage.
Mm-hmm.
I have given the dearly beloved of my soul into the hand of her enemy.
Mm-hmm.
My heritage is unto me as a lion in the forest.
Mm-hmm.
It crieth out against me.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore have I hated it.
Uh-huh.
Mine heritage is unto me as a speckled bird.
Uh-huh.
The birds round about are against her.
Now, we stand out like a sore thumb, like a speckled bird, and all everybody else is against us. You walk into the room, six white people there, they going to, and you ain't did nothing.
Nothing.
I don't know how many times I've heard on TV when somebody telling about a lie about some crime, they say, well, it was a black man did this. Hmm. And right away, everybody, so they ain't question it.
Right.
Let's go look for the black man.
Right,
you look like the one.
Right.
Because they're afraid of you,
yeah,
because the Lord put this on them to be that way and to fear you. Because you are like a speckled bird. Everybody going to be hating you. Okay, but go ahead.
Come ye.
Mm-hmm.
Assemble all the beasts of the field.
Uh-huh.
Come to devour.
Now, everybody get to devour you. And get away with it. Look at all these kids getting shot and killed by police officers. And then when they go to court, they walk out free. And now they're trying to pass a law now that the police officer is going to have civil rights. That's just to protect them more so they don't do that. Because now, if somebody gets shot or killed, they cover it up. They hide it so you can't see it. So now they're going to try to get these groups of people that they appoint to oversee them. How come they don't vote for one of y'all to be on that committee? Let me on there. Guilty, guilty, guilty. But that ain't going to happen, right? Why? Because you in captivity. You ain't got a chain on you at all. But you ain't got no control, but you think you do. Wake up, people. Wake up. Okay, but go ahead.
Many pastors have destroyed my vineyard.
Whoa, now he hit the nail on the head, didn't he?
Yeah.
Who destroyed the vineyard? The preachers. Because they ain't telling you no truth. They lying to you, and they just want your money. The book said, why are you spending your bread for that which is money for that which is not bread?
That's right.
You go to church dumb, you come out dumb. You wasting your time. Do that for your children in school. You be asking, where your homework at?
Right, right.
Maybe the kids should ask you, Mom, where your homework at?
Right.
What you learned in church today? You a flunk to test. I know some people don't know where the books of the Bible. You been going to church 20 years. You don't know where Genesis is? Come on. That's serious. That's a serious flaw, ain't it?
Yeah.
And y'all know, y'all first came here, y'all fumbling through the... Well, I've been going to church for 19 years. Don't even know where a book in the Bible is. You have to be taught. But the preachers are the ones that destroy the Lord's vineyard. Okay, go ahead.
They have trodden my portion underfoot.
Mm-hmm.
They have made my pleasant portion, mm-hmm, a desolate wilderness.
Ain't that something? Because everybody pluck at you. If you hear some of the stories, I get some things that happen to some people. Man, that happened to you? Yeah, man. When? Last week. Treacherous stuff. And I hate hearing those stories, but I know where we at, and I know where we in. My eyes ain't shut. Wide open, okay? Now, go to Jeremiah, the 15th chapter. Jeremiah 15. And pick it up at verse 1. Jeremiah 15 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Then said the Lord unto me,
mm-hmm,
though Moses and Samuel stood before me,
mm-hmm,
yet my mind could not be toward this people.
Uh-huh.
Cast them out of my sight,
mm-hmm,
and let them go forth.
Uh-huh.
And it shall come to pass, if they say unto thee, Whither shall we go for? Mm-hmm. Then thou shalt tell them, mm-hmm. thus saith the Lord, mm-hmm. such as for death to death,
uh-huh.
and such as for the sword to the sword,
uh-huh.
and such as for the famine to the famine, mm-hmm. and such as for the captivity mm-hmm. to the captivity.
Ain't that something? Because Israel always asking at the last minute, why are you going to put us out? Why are you putting me out? And where I'm going to go? And Lord say, I'm going to tell you where you're going. To death, famine, sword, or what? Captivity. Which one you prefer?
Right.
Right? I'd rather be in captivity without chains than to get hit with a sword or famine or death. Right? So he gave him a choice. Okay, but go ahead.
And I will appoint over them four kinds, mm-hmm. saith the Lord.
Uh-huh.
The sword to slay,
mm-hmm.
and the dogs to tear,
mm-hmm.
and the fowls of the heaven,
uh-huh.
Of the heaven, and the beasts of the earth
uh-huh.
to devour and destroy.
Uh-huh.
And I will cause them to be removed into all kingdoms of the earth.
Wait, but just in Brazil.
All kingdoms.
Some people need to read that all kingdoms, because
yeah,
they got this 12 tribe chart. They got everybody in the foul
that's
Israel.
Right. That's right.
He said all kingdoms on earth. And that is true. Watch some international stuff. Look in the back. You ain't gonna be in the front, but look in the back. And you'll see Israel like walk right past. I've been telling my wife, put that on pause. Is that Israel? That's Israel back there. In some Timbuktu, some town somewhere that you ain't thought no Israelite would be. And they're right there. In all kingdoms on the earth. We're gonna show you that too, because when the Lord say he's gonna gather Israel, he gotta gather them from where? All kingdoms on the earth. Don't let nobody fool you with no 12 chart. Well, trap chart. Come on, go ahead.
Because of Manasseh, the son of Hezekiah,
mm-hmm.
king of Judah,
mm-hmm.
for that which he did in Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
For who shall have pity upon thee, O Jerusalem?
Mm-hmm.
Or who shall bemoan thee?
Uh-huh.
Or who shall go aside to ask how thou doest?
Is anybody asking how your plight is going? You may go to work and they say, how you doing? Oh, I'm doing fine. That's it.
Right.
I want to hear about your suffering and your affliction. I don't want to hear that. I don't hear about Bebe and Pookie and who in jail and who got shot and all. Because if you want to hear, I got a long list I can tell you. Right? Crazy stuff that happened to us. We can come work. We got stories. They come work. Oh, we just went to the zoo this weekend and had such a good time. You struggling to make it back to work. Right? Car broke down.
Right.
House on fire. All these afflictions happened to you. Everybody else all good. They prosper, you struggling. But don't nobody see that plight with these false prophets, because that's how they make their money. I know what you're suffering with. Come to the Lord. Pass this tray around. Come all smooth, right? But they taking advantage of you, and the world is taking advantage of you. But who put that on you? You did, because you didn't do what the Lord said to do.
That's right.
Your forefathers, I would like to meet my uncle that did this. Which one of y'all was that said, we're going to go over here and worship this idol? Point them out. Because y'all messed everybody up. Okay, but go ahead.
Thou hast forsaken me,
mm-hmm.
saith the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Thou art going backward.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore will I stretch out my hand against thee
mm-hmm.
and destroy thee.
Uh-huh.
I am weary with repentance.
Because don't Israel say, forgive me. Lord say, he done with you repenting. I done saved you, I don't know how many times, and brought you back into the land. You keep messing up. Keep worshiping other God. He said, I'm weary with repentance. Okay, go ahead.
And I will fan them with the fan in the gates of the land.
Uh-huh.
I will bereave them of children.
Mm-hmm.
I will destroy my people
uh-huh.
since they return not from their ways.
Ain't that something? So who destroying you? The Lord is. And he's using everybody on this earth to devour and spoil you. You can cry all you want. The Lord said, he was done with repenting. Here come the curses. Now you got to deal with them curses. Okay, now. Let's go to Hosea, the fifth chapter. Hosea 5. Because you know, the Lord is a very patient God. I can show y'all some scripture. How he's so patient with Israel. And Israel still going to turn against the Lord. I'm going to do what I'm going to do. I'm going to serve the way I want to serve. And they serve their way. Clean out the Bible. Clean out. Hosea 5 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Hear ye this, O priest.
Now, who is he talking to first?
The preacher.
Okay, go ahead.
And hearken,
mm-hmm.
ye house of Israel,
mm-hmm.
and give ye ear,
uh-huh.
O house of the king,
mm-hmm.
for judgment is toward you,
mm-hmm.
because ye have been a snare upon Mizpah,
uh-huh.
and a net spread upon Tabor.
Uh-huh.
And the revolters are profound to make slaughter,
uh-huh.
though I have been a rebuker of them all.
Now, a rebuker of just a few of them.
Of all
of them. And you know there's a lot of false prophets out here, so the Lord been against all of them. Okay, but go ahead.
I know Ephraim, mm-hmm. and Israel is not hid from me. Mm-hmm. For now, O Ephraim, mm-hmm. thou committest whoredom, mm-hmm. and Israel is defiled.
Uh-huh.
They will not frame their doings to turn unto their God.
Uh-huh.
For the spirit of whoredoms is in the midst of them, uh-huh. and they have not known the Lord.
Now, what do you mean, spirit of whoredom? You mean false doctrine. You want to be with every other God but your God. Because you're a little whore, you want to just open up your legs to everybody to pass by.
That's right.
I can read that to you out the scripture.
That's right.
And that's where Israel is. Okay, but go ahead.
And the pride of Israel don't testify to his face.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore shall Israel and Ephraim fall in their iniquity.
Uh-huh.
Judah also shall fall with them.
Mm-hmm.
They shall go with their flocks mm-hmm. and with their herds mm-hmm. to seek the Lord.
Uh-huh.
But they shall not find him.
Mm-hmm.
He hath withdrawn himself from them.
Now you're going to go looking for him. He'll say,
bingo.
Get out of my face.
Right.
Go get them gods you've been praying with.
That's right.
I'm sending afflictions. I'm sending curses. You ain't going to find me. Because the Lord know how to push out punishment. Okay, skip down to verse 14.
For I will be unto Ephraim as a lion,
mm-hmm.
and as a young lion to the house of Judah.
Mm-hmm.
I mm-hmm. will tear and go away.
Uh-huh.
I will take away, and none shall rescue him.
Now, who going to come and save you? Nobody. Because who is your savior? The Lord. And if he ain't saving you, you ain't got nothing coming. Ain't nobody gonna rescue you. Okay, go ahead.
I will go and return to my place
mm-hmm.
till they acknowledge their offense
mm-hmm.
and seek my face.
Uh-huh.
In their affliction, they will seek me early.
Right away, because the Lord gonna put some affliction on Israel. And right away, they said, Lord, Lord, help me. He said, no, no. I'm gonna wait 400 years. I'm gonna wait 600 years. I'm gonna wait 1,000 years till you acknowledge your offense and turn back to me. And we're not acknowledging it as a nation because the preachers ain't teaching it as a nation. Okay, now. Let's go to Jeremiah, the 23rd chapter. Jeremiah 23. Because these false prophets think they're getting away. They're not getting away. They're just getting by. And it's going to be a bad day for them when the Lord get here. Because I tell you, I wouldn't want to be one of them. I'm careful with my tongue, and I don't want to give nobody any wrong advice. They giving it every Sunday.
Yeah, purpose.
Without fail. Yep. Jeremiah 23 and verse 1. Go ahead.
Woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, mm-hmm. saith the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, thus saith the Lord God of Israel mm-hmm. against the pastors that feed my people.
Uh-huh.
Ye have scattered my flock
mm-hmm.
and driven them away,
uh-huh.
and have not visited them.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doing, saith the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And I will gather the remnant of my flock
mm-hmm.
out of all the countries whither I have driven them,
uh-huh.
and will bring them again to their fold,
mm-hmm.
and they shall be fruitful and increase.
Uh-huh.
And I will set up shepherds over them mm-hmm. which shall feed them,
mm-hmm.
and they shall fear no more, nor be dismayed,
mm-hmm.
neither shall they be lacking, saith the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Behold,
mm-hmm.
the days come, saith the Lord,
mm-hmm.
that I will raise unto David a righteous branch,
mm-hmm.
and a king shall reign and prosper,
mm-hmm.
and shall execute judgment and justice in the earth.
Uh-huh.
In his days Judah shall be saved,
mm-hmm.
and Israel shall dwell safely,
mm-hmm.
and this is his name whereby he shall be called,
mm-hmm.
the Lord our righteousness.
So now we know the Lord ain't here, right? Because otherwise we'd be dwelling in our land, right? And we'd be safe. Are they safe over there in Israel right now?
Yes,
apparently not. Okay, but go ahead.
Therefore,
mm-hmm.
behold, the days come, saith the Lord,
mm-hmm.
and they shall no more say,
mm-hmm.
the Lord liveth,
mm-hmm.
which brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt.
Uh-huh.
But the Lord liveth,
mm-hmm.
which brought up and which led the seed of the house of Israel
mm-hmm.
out of the north country,
mm-hmm.
and from all countries whither I had driven them,
uh-huh.
and they shall dwell in their own land.
Because the Lord got to gather Israel from all the nations on his earth, right?
Right.
And then he going to gather us. We ain't going to talk about Egypt no more. We're going to talk about world gathering when the Lord going to do it. Okay, now, let's go to Ezekiel, the 34th chapter. Ezekiel 34. Because the Egypt was just a prototype on how the Lord going to do when he come in the end. And at his second coming, he going to whoop this earth like he whooped Egypt. But nobody paying that no attention. Some people did. They made a movie about the Exodus again, showing why, you know, this lady asked, why you not gonna kill my baby? You ain't Israel. Probably why. But they do know that something is gonna happen in the future, the same way it happened in the Bible in Egypt. Okay, but now, Ezekiel 34 and verse 1. Go ahead.
And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying,
mm-hmm.
Son of man,
uh-huh.
prophesy against the shepherds of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
Prophesy and say unto them,
mm-hmm.
thus saith the Lord God unto the shepherds,
mm-hmm.
woe be to the shepherds of Israel that mm-hmm. do feed themselves.
Uh-huh.
Should not the shepherds feed the flocks?
Mm-hmm.
Ye eat the fat,
mm-hmm.
and ye clothe you with the wool.
Uh-huh.
Ye kill them that are fed,
mm-hmm.
but ye feed not the flock.
And all you got to do is, the simple thing is, Precept upon precept.
That's right.
Line upon line. Here a little and there a little. But do they do that? No. Some of them just go down to Moody Bible Institute, buy a sermon, and preach that sermon.
That's right.
Some title that somebody gave them. You ain't read out the Bible yourself, you're going to read what somebody else going to give you. That ain't no preacher. Plain and simple. Okay, but go ahead.
The disease have ye not strengthened.
Mm-hmm.
Neither have ye healed that which was sick.
Uh-huh.
Neither have ye bound up that which was broken.
Mm-hmm.
Neither have ye brought again that which was driven away.
Mm-hmm.
Neither have ye sought that which was lost.
Uh-huh.
But with force and with cruelty have ye ruled them.
Mm-hmm.
And they were scattered,
uh-huh,
because there is no shepherd.
Mm-hmm.
And it became meat to all the beasts of the field,
uh-huh,
when they were scattered.
So now, because the shepherd's teaching them lies, then everybody can come and spoil them because ain't nobody seeking the truth. Because all you gotta do is heal the people with the word of God. That's all you gotta do.
That's
okay,
right.
Go ahead.
My sheep wandered through all the mountains,
mm-hmm,
and upon every high hill.
Uh-huh.
Yea, my flock was scattered upon all the face of the earth,
uh-huh,
and none did search or seek after them.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, ye shepherds, hear the word of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
As I live, saith the Lord God,
uh-huh,
surely because my flock became a prey,
mm-hmm,
and my flock became meat to every beast of the field,
mm-hmm,
because there was no shepherd,
uh-huh,
neither did my shepherds search for my flock,
mm-hmm,
but the shepherds fed themselves,
mm-hmm,
and fed not my flock.
Now, could we read that today? What's going on with these preachers? They feeding themselves. They ain't feeding the flock. Okay, go ahead.
Therefore, O ye shepherds,
mm-hmm,
hear the word of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Thus saith the Lord God,
mm-hmm,
behold, I am against the shepherds,
mm-hmm,
and I will require my flock at their hand,
mm-hmm,
and cause them to cease from feeding the flock.
Mm-hmm.
Neither shall the shepherds feed themselves anymore,
uh-huh,
for I will deliver my flock from their mouth,
mm-hmm,
that they may not be meat for them.
Mm-hmm.
For thus saith the Lord God,
mm-hmm,
behold, I, even I,
mm-hmm,
will both search my sheep, mm-hmm, and seek them out.
Uh-huh.
As a shepherd seeketh out his flock in the day that he is among his sheep,
mm-hmm,
that are scattered,
uh-huh,
so will I seek out my sheep,
mm-hmm,
and will deliver them out of all the places,
mm-hmm,
where they have been scattered, mm-hmm, in the cloud. Cloudy and dark day.
Because that cloudy and dark day gonna come. But the Lord know his sheep, right? And his sheep know him. So is everybody can come as you are? I don't think so.
No.
You better know who the Lord is when he comes, because you know you got some truth. Okay, but go ahead.
And I will bring them out from the people,
uh-huh,
and gather them from the country,
mm-hmm,
and will bring them to their own land,
mm-hmm,
and feed them upon the mountains of Israel, mm-hmm, by the rivers,
uh-huh,
and in all the inhabited places of the country.
Now, who gonna gather Israel? The Lord. All these brothers talking about we're going to go back to Israel in 2019. Don't listen to that. Wait for the Lord to bring you. The closest you're going to get to the land is being in the wilderness, a place safe. That's it. You go any further than that, you're going to have a time of trouble like it never was before. So don't listen to these guys talking about 2019. Okay. Now, let's go to Jeremiah, the 50th chapter. Jeremiah 50. Because when the Lord start gathering Israel, they're going to be happy. They're going to be crying. And they're going to be wondering how long, why would it took so long? And how come we were so fooled? And how come didn't nobody tell us the truth? And we got caught up in this mess. Because you wouldn't listen. And you didn't seek out the Lord. Okay? Jeremiah 50 and verse 1. Go ahead.
The word that the Lord spake against Babylon, mm-hmm, and against the land of, mm-hmm, the Chaldeans, mm-hmm, by Jeremiah the prophet.
Now, this was written by Jeremiah the prophet, but we're talking end time, and you're going to see us talking about end time. Okay, go ahead.
Declare ye among the nations,
mm-hmm,
and publish,
mm-hmm,
and set up a standard.
Mm-hmm.
Publish and conceal not.
Mm-hmm.
Say,
mm-hmm,
Babylon is taken.
Uh-huh.
Baal is confounded.
Mm-hmm.
Merodach is broken in pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Her idols are confounded.
Mm-hmm.
Her images are broken in pieces.
Now, he's talking about, you know, Babylon and all that. People think Babylon is just the United States. Babylon is this whole world where Gentiles are in control.
Right.
Okay, but go ahead.
For out of the north, there cometh up a nation against her,
uh-huh,
which shall make her land desolate,
mm-hmm,
and none shall dwell therein.
Uh-huh.
They shall remove,
mm-hmm,
they shall depart,
mm-hmm,
both man and beast.
Uh-huh.
In those days and in that time, saith the Lord,
mm-hmm,
the children of Israel shall come,
uh-huh,
they and the children of Judah together,
mm-hmm,
going and weeping.
Mm-hmm.
They shall go and seek the Lord their God.
Now, why are they weeping? Because they done got whooped up for 3.5 years. If you get caught up in this great tribulation, you're going to be glad when it's over, because now you know the Lord coming to save you. Okay, go ahead.
They shall ask the way to Zion, mm-hmm, with their faces thither, uh-huh, we're saying,
mm-hmm,
come and let us join ourselves to the Lord in a perpetual covenant,
mm-hmm,
that shall not be forgotten.
Now they're going to want to keep the law now.
Right.
You tell them about the law now, we ain't got to keep that old cursed law.
Mm-hmm.
But after this whooping you're going to get, you would say, let's take me to Zion. Take me straight there.
Right.
Teach me all them laws. because I don't want to get caught up in this again. Okay, but go ahead.
My people have been lost sheep.
Mm-hmm.
Their shepherds have caused them to go astray.
Mm-hmm.
They have turned them away on the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
They have gone from mountain to hill.
Mm-hmm.
They have forgotten their resting place.
Uh-huh.
All that found them have devoured them.
Mm-hmm.
And their adversary said,
uh-huh,
we offend not,
mm-hmm,
because they have sinned against the Lord.
They're going to say, hey, you know, we didn't ask for this authority, but y'all sinned. We took advantage. Yes, we did. Yes, we did. But we ain't offend. No, we ain't offend. Y'all put yourself in that spot. And they ain't going to feel guilty at all, don't they?
Nope.
What does Zechariah say? That they rich, Lord, bless me because I am rich and I got all these slaves?
Right.
Because they took advantage, but the Lord gave. But they say, we offend not because y'all the one that sinned. Okay, go ahead.
The habitation of justice,
mm-hmm,
even the Lord,
mm-hmm,
the hope of their fathers.
Uh-huh.
Remove out of the midst of Babylon,
mm-hmm,
and go forth out of the land of the Chaldeans,
mm-hmm,
and be as the he-goats before the flock.
Uh-huh.
For lo,
mm-hmm,
I will raise and cause to come up against Babylon, mm-hmm, an assembly of great nations,
mm-hmm,
from the north country.
Uh-huh.
And they shall set themselves in array against her.
Mm-hmm.
From thence she shall be taken.
Uh-huh.
Their arrows shall be as of a mighty expert man.
Mm-hmm.
None shall return in vain.
Uh-huh.
And Chaldeans shall be a spoil.
Mm-hmm.
All the spoil her shall be satisfied, saith the Lord.
Because the time gonna come, the Lord gonna turn this thing upside down. And he gonna have the people come at those nations that spoiled you to take over this earth. And the Lord gonna let them do the fight. And he said, not one arrow gonna go out vain. But when they start shooting, it's gonna hit what is its target.
That's right.
Plain and simple. Okay, go ahead.
Because ye were glad.
Mm-hmm.
Because ye rejoiced.
Mm-hmm.
O ye destroyers of mine heritage.
Uh-huh.
Because ye are grown fat as the heifer, mm-hmm, at grass,
mm-hmm,
and bellow as bulls.
Mm-hmm.
Your mother shall be sore confounded.
Uh-huh.
She that bare you shall be ashamed.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, the hindermost of the nations shall be a wilderness,
mm-hmm,
a dry land, mm-hmm, and a desert.
That don't sound like a good time, do it?
No, sir.
We talking future. This ain't happened yet. And I don't know why people ain't studying the Bible and reading the same thing we reading. You don't take no college degree to get this. All you got to do is read. Okay, go ahead.
Because of the wrath of the Lord, mm-hmm, it shall not be inhabited,
uh-huh,
but it shall wholly be desolate.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone that goeth by Babylon shall be astonished,
mm-hmm,
and hiss at all her plagues.
Uh-huh.
Put yourselves in array against Babylon, mm-hmm, round about.
Uh-huh.
All ye that bend the bow,
mm-hmm,
shoot at her.
Uh-huh.
Spare no arrows,
mm-hmm,
for she hath sinned against the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Shout against her round about.
Mm-hmm.
She hath given her hand. Her foundations are fallen.
Mm-hmm.
Her walls are thrown down.
Mm-hmm.
For it is the vengeance of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Take vengeance upon her.
Mm-hmm.
As she hath done, do, mm-hmm, unto her.
Ain't that something? I bet the people that were in Jericho, when they thought they was protected until that wall fell down, right?
Right.
These people gonna be saying, I'm in the bunker over here. I got this bunker over here. Lord say, shoot your arrow, that bunker gonna fall. Or open wide up, open. Because them arrows, when they come, when them guns, when they come, and them missiles, when they come, they gonna hit their target. Because the Lord aiming at you, you going to get hit. The Lord talking about setting a plummet, don't it? Even in carpentry, because he want to be accurate. And that's what it's all about. Okay, but go ahead.
Cut off the sword from Babylon,
mm-hmm,
and him that handleth the sickle, mm-hmm, in the time of harvest.
Uh-huh.
For fear of the oppressing sword, they shall turn everyone to his people,
mm-hmm,
and they shall flee everyone to his own land.
Everybody going to be going back to their own country. I'm from Italy. I'm going back to Italy. I'm from Poland. I'm going back to Poland. You gonna be? I'm going back to Africa. You ain't going to Africa. You going to Israel.
That's right.
I'm going to Georgia. Cause they don't know where their homeland is.
Right.
But at this time, people gonna know that hey, it's time for us to get protection. We gotta go back to our people, our nation. Okay, go ahead.
Israel is a scattered sheep.
Mm-hmm.
The lions have driven him away.
Uh-huh.
First, the king of Assyria has devoured him.
Uh-huh.
And last, this Nebuchadnezzar, mm-hmm, king of Babylon, mm-hmm, have broken his bones.
Now, is our bones still being broken? Yes. Are we still under Gentile rulership? Yes. But the Lord said he is the last, because after him, no, we ain't had no more problem.
That's right.
Because the Lord going to be here after this. Okay, but go ahead.
Therefore,
mm-hmm,
thus saith the Lord of hosts,
mm-hmm,
the God of Israel,
uh-huh,
behold, I will punish the king of Babylon, mm-hmm, and his land,
mm-hmm,
as I punish the king of Assyria.
Mm-hmm.
And I will bring Israel again to his habitation,
mm-hmm,
and he shall feed on Carmel and Bashan.
Uh-huh.
And his soul shall be satisfied upon Mount Ephraim, mm-hmm, and Gilead.
Uh-huh.
In those days and in that time, saith the Lord,
mm-hmm,
the iniquity of Israel shall be sought for,
mm-hmm,
and there shall be none.
Uh-huh.
And the sins of Judah,
mm-hmm,
and they shall not be found.
Uh-huh.
For I will pardon them whom I reserve.
So now, so is it going to be any more sinning in the land when the Lord get here?
No, sir.
So are they sitting in the land right now? So you know we're talking future.
That's right.
We're not talking present day. We're talking about something going to happen in the future when the Lord going to come and he's going to make sure that the righteous going to be in the land. Plain and simple. Okay, now skip down to verse 33.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts.
Uh-huh.
The children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together.
Uh-huh.
And all that took them captives held them fast.
Uh-huh.
They refused to let them go.
Didn't Joseph have to ask permission to leave Egypt? Don't you think Belteshazzar and Nebuchadnezzar didn't want Daniel to go nowhere? They kept him in the land. But if he couldn't go back to Israel, could he?
Nope.
Can you go back to your land right now?
Nope.
No, you can't. But the Lord said when he returned, we still going to be in captivity because everybody refused to let us go. Okay, but go ahead.
Their Redeemer is strong.
Uh-huh.
The Lord of hosts is his name.
Mm-hmm.
He shall thoroughly plead their cause
uh-huh.
that he may give rest to the land
mm-hmm.
and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon.
He's going to shut Babylon down and put you back in the land. I can read you scripture where you can put up, they're going to be putting their hands over their mouth and say, oh, that's them. Them the true Jews. And they're going to be in shock because it's going to be you. Okay. Now, let's go to Jeremiah, the 51st chapter, and pick it up at verse 1. Go ahead.
Thus saith the Lord,
mm-hmm.
behold, I will raise up against Babylon
mm-hmm.
and against them that dwell in the midst of them that
mm-hmm.
rise up against me,
mm-hmm.
a destroying wind,
mm-hmm.
and will send unto Babylon fanners
mm-hmm.
that shall fan her
uh-huh.
and shall empty her land.
Mm-hmm.
For in the day of trouble, they shall be against her round about.
Uh-huh.
Against him that bendeth, let the archer bend his bow,
mm-hmm.
and against him that lifted himself up in his brigandine.
Mm-hmm.
And spare ye not her young men,
mm-hmm.
destroy ye utterly all her hosts.
Uh-huh.
Thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans
mm-hmm.
and they that are thrust through in her streets.
Mm-hmm.
For Israel have not been forsaken,
mm-hmm.
nor Judah of his God,
uh-huh.
of the Lord of hosts,
mm-hmm.
though their land was filled with sin mm-hmm. against the Holy One of Israel.
So the Lord, people saying the Lord had cast the Jews away.
No, sir.
Lord said he ain't forgot his people. He's going to always remember his people. Okay, but go ahead.
Flee out of the midst of Babylon
uh-huh.
and deliver every man his soul.
Mm-hmm.
Be not cut off in her iniquity.
Uh-huh.
For this is the time of the Lord's vengeance.
Mm-hmm.
He will render unto her a recompense.
So now you're going to have to make a choice in that day. Whose side you going to be on? The Pope or the Lord? Because it's going to be a battle between them two. And you better be on the Lord's side, okay? But go ahead.
Babylon have been a golden cup in the Lord's hand
uh-huh.
that made all the earth drunken.
Now, what? How'd he make us drunk? Christmas,
that's right.
Paul's Easter,
that's right.
Halloween, New Year's Eve. All them pagan days, people been drunk and they still drunk. You tell them it's pagan, they still gonna get drunk. Well, I'm gonna do it for the kids. Okay, Lord gonna be looking for you on that time of trouble. Okay, but go ahead.
The nations have drunken of her wine.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, the nations are mad.
Mm-hmm.
Babylon is suddenly fallen mm-hmm. and destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
Howl for her. Take balm for her pain.
Mm-hmm.
If so be, she may be healed.
Mm-hmm.
We would have healed Babylon,
mm-hmm.
but she is not healed.
Mm-hmm.
Forsake her
uh-huh.
and let us go everyone into his own country.
Mm-hmm.
For her judgment reacheth unto heaven
mm-hmm.
and is lifted up even to the sky.
Uh-huh.
The Lord hath brought forth our righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
Come and let us declare in Zion the work of the Lord our God.
Uh-huh.
Make bright the arrow.
Mm-hmm.
Gather the shield.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord hath raised up the spear of the kings of the Medes.
Mm-hmm.
For his device is against Babylon.
Uh-huh.
To destroy it.
Now, don't you know right now, the Medes, which we call Russia, is not with the Catholic Church. They ain't even trying to be with America, right? Trump trying to get over there and use them or get money from them. But bottom line is, the Russians are going to be the main ones and his allies to come and work for the Lord during this time. He's going to let them do all the killing. Okay, but go ahead.
Because it is the vengeance of the Lord,
mm-hmm.
the vengeance of his temple.
Uh-huh.
Set up the standard upon the walls of Babylon.
Mm-hmm.
Make the watch strong.
Mm-hmm.
Set up the watchmen.
Uh-huh.
Prepare the ambushes.
Mm-hmm.
For the Lord hath both devised and done that which he spake against the inhabitants of Babylon.
Uh-huh.
O thou that dwellest upon many waters,
uh-huh.
abundant in treasure,
mm-hmm.
thine end is come,
uh-huh.
and the measure of thy covetousness.
Now, let me show you who these many waters is now. It ain't any less, but I got to show you. But he said, thou that dwellest upon many waters. Let's go to Revelation 17 chapter.
That's right.
Revelation 17. Because most people don't know that the Catholic Church is running their life.
Yep.
Everything you do is, you go to church on Sunday, that's Catholic.
Yep.
You celebrate all them pagan days, that's Catholic. You say your day started at 12:01 a.m. That's Catholic. You say your weekdays is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Sunday. The Bible say 1 through 6. And what's the seventh day? The Sabbath. You got January, February, March, April, all them pagan, except for August. That's Augustus. Right? All that paganism come from the Catholic Church. Now, Revelation 17 and verse 1. Go ahead.
And there came one of the seven angels which had the seven vials and talked with me, saying unto me, come hither. I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters.
Now, the Lord called her a great whore, right? Why is she a great whore? Because she's the mother of harlots. Skip down to verse 5.
And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth.
Now, why is she the mother of harlots? Mama said go to church on Sunday. That's the right. Harlots do it.
That's right.
Mama said celebrate Christmas. The harlots do it. But let's see what the many waters is. Skip down to verse 15.
And he saith unto me, the waters which thou sawest where the whore sitteth are peoples and multitudes and nations and tongues.
So now she sit up on many waters, right? She's in control of a lot of people. Don't you know the Catholic Church is the biggest religion on the planet? Yeah. And she sits up on many waters, but the Lord said he going to destroy her. So is he talking about the United States? He's talking about, no, wherever you got a Catholic, that's where the Lord going to be tearing up. Go down to the little deepest, darkest spot in Africa. You're going to see a big cross down there. He's going to tear that up, too.
Yep.
Some missionaries have been down there. No problem. We're going to tear them, too. Because the Lord's going to do some killing when he get here. Okay? Now, let's go to Jeremiah 31st chapter. I just had to show y'all that since we read right into it. Jeremiah 31. This will be last. Jeremiah 31 and verse 1. Go ahead.
And at that time, saith the Lord, will I be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus saith the Lord, the people which were left of the sword found grace in the wilderness, even Israel, when I went to cause him to rest.
So now, why are we going to find grace in the wilderness? Because during that time of great tribulation, if we're in the wilderness, the place of safety, we're going to find rest for 3.5 years. Okay, go ahead.
The Lord have appeared of old unto me, saying, yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn thee.
Wait a minute. I thought the Lord cast Israel away.
Everlasting love.
He said everlasting love. Okay, but go ahead.
Again, I will build thee, and thou shalt be built, O virgin of Israel. Thou shalt again be adorned with thy tabrets, and shalt go forth in the dances of them that make merry.
Skip down to verse 10.
Hear the word of the Lord, O ye nations, and declare in the isles afar off, and say, he that scattered Israel will gather him, and keep him as a shepherd doth his flock. For the Lord hath redeemed Jacob, and ransomed him from the hand of him that was stronger than he.
Now, if he got to ransom you, where you at? In captivity.
That's right.
Didn't he do that when he brought you out of Egypt? He delivered you out of Egypt? He got to deliver us out of this cruel world that we're in right now, because it's been holding us as captive. Just that simple, okay? Skip down to verse 31.
Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, which my covenant they break, although I was an husband unto them, saith the Lord. But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, saith the Lord, I will put my law in their inward parts and write it in their hearts and will be their God and they shall be my people.
So now the Lord gonna put his laws in your hearts and in your mind, right? He did that when he came and died on the cross. He made a new covenant with Israel to give you back access to eternal life that Adam took from you. And he gave you access to get your sins forgiven. Okay, but go ahead.
And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor and every man his brother, saying, know the Lord.
Now, do we still gotta teach that today, right? So we're talking future with that. Okay, but go ahead.
For they shall all know me, from the least of them unto the greatest of them, saith the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more.
Now, when is that going to happen? After you come down here and destroy this world and clean up Jerusalem and bring the righteous over there, then ain't going to be no more sin over there. You do that, you're going to be a dead man. Plain and simple. Okay, but go ahead.
Thus saith the Lord, which giveth the sun for a light by day, and the ordinances of the moon and of the stars for a light by night, which divideth the sea when the waves thereof roar. The Lord of hosts is his name. If those ordinances depart from before me, saith the Lord, then the seed of Israel also shall cease from being a nation before me forever.
So now, as long as we got a sun, the moon, and the sky, Israel's still the chosen people.
That's right.
That's what the Lord telling you. Yep. Because when somebody tell you the Lord cast Israel away, he said, bring the moon and the sun down. Then I'll do that.
That's right.
But as long as you got day and night, Israel still chosen. Okay, go ahead.
Thus saith the Lord, mm-hmm. if heaven above can be measured, mm-hmm. and the foundations of the earth searched out beneath, uh-huh. I will also cast off all the seed of Israel mm-hmm. for all that they have done, mm-hmm. saith the Lord.
Now, can you measure the heavens? Can you measure the earth?
No.
They still guessing. Saying the sun, the moon is 500 light years away. What's a light year? Right? Come on. They can't measure it, so Israel is still the chosen people. Who gonna gather Israel? The Lord. Gather them out of what? Captivity. Without chain. We don't even know we in captivity. But when the Lord come, he gonna ransom his people and get his people back, and they can't, the world can't do nothing about it. It's gonna happen. They wanna keep you because you a good servant now. They tried the Indians. The Indians didn't work. They didn't work. But when they brought them Israelites, smack up that whip. What you want me to do? Everybody else run and get away. But we can't run. We can't. I don't know. The Lord just took all our speed from us at the set time. Because if you can get caught as a nation and be brought in captivity and nobody stop it, you know the Lord did that to you. As strong as we are, we got some brothers here almost 7 foot tall, 300-400 pounds. Come on. Who going to pull him down? Crazy, but this thing happened, right? And we're not going to be out of this captivity until the Lord comes. Don't let nobody fool you to think you're just going to go over back to Israel and say, I'm free and I'm back in my land. Go over there and look without some money and redemption. Redemption got to be the first thing you have. Just that simple. So that's the lesson, captivity without chains. I hope somebody got some understanding. I thank you for your time.